चीफ खालसा दीवान इंटरनेशनल नर्सिंग कॉलेज जो कि चबाल रोड जिला अमृतसर विखे स्थित है। एक कॉलेज अपने इलाके विच बहुत ही वधिया तरीके नाल अपनी सेवावां निभा रहा है। बीते दिन फर्स्ट इंटरनेशनल नर्सिंग कॉन्फ्रेंस 2018 ऑन अनफोल्डिंग द मिजरीज ऑफ ए कैंसर पेशेंट्स मीटी 14 to 16 November के विच हुई। इस मौके मुख्य मेहमान वजो प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर राज बहादुर ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर बाबा फरीद यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हेल्थ साइंसिज विशेष तौर पर पुजे। 3 दिन की कॉन्फ्रेंस में सब ने बढ़ चढ़ के इस विच हिस्सा लिया। इस मौके साड़ी पंजाब प्लस की टीम ने विशेष दौरा किया। पेश है पंजाब प्लस की टीम वालों एक रिपोर्ट।
कल लैक्चर सी पैनल डिस्कशन जरा कल वाला आने वाला कल है उदन पैनल डिस्कशन ने एक्सपर्ट्स के लैक्चर ने ये किया असी कि वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ कैंसर के बारे लोगों अवेयरनैस देने वास्ते कॉमन टाइप्स है किमें इन्हों प्रिवेंट किया जा सकता है इन्हों के कॉमन साइन सिमटम्स की है कि असी अलग अलग जगह तो अलग अलग स्टेट्स तो अलग अलग कंट्री के उत्तों असी एक्सपर्ट बुलाए साढ़े को एक्सपर्ट्स के USA तो मैडम बैठे ने बाद सुरेश खन्ना हांगकॉन्ग तो भी मैडम ने श्रीलंका तो साउथ अफ्रीका वैसट अफ्रीका पाकिस्तान बांग्लादेश मालदीव
सर चीफ खालसा दीवान द्वारा इस गल कि लोगों को अवेयर किया जाए कि अज जी नाम बीमारी बड़ी तेजी बढ़ रही है कैंसर वाली बीमारी जिस कैंसर है
Yeah. together in order to achieve our vision. And our mission is to relieve the global burden of cancer and advanced stage diseases by increasing access to and utilization of evidence-based knowledge that nurses can employ in order to improve the health and well-being of people. Research health promotion projects, which in order to facilitate the project that help people adopt healthier lifestyle, or the other option is seed funding scheme. In order to facilitate the research for health promotion in the community and engage the partnership between the public, private, and non-government organizations. So at that time, we would like to choose the one with larger amount of resources, the seed funding scheme, because our ultimate goal is to engage the community and to ensure the sustainability of our interventions. Okay. So because of this, so we developed another project. And the title of this project is Development of the Multimedia Interventions to Promote the Breast Cancer Preventions Among the South Asian Women in Hong Kong. Now, although the findings of the study not only limited to breast cancer preventions, but in order to make more focus, so we would like to target the breast cancer prevention first. Because this is the most popular common cancer among women in Hong Kong. And second, so we would like to engage with women first. So we submit another proposal. The challenges is similar to the previous one. The successful rate is very, very limited, very low, it's about 30%. However, if we are able to beat it, so we will have the resources to provide and to develop the information and to serve the community.
Panelists and the present, currently presenting all the dignified members from different countries, the faculties of the college and my dear students. So today, in this panel discussion, we are going to discuss various aspects of psycho-oncology. The name of the discussion has been taped whether psycho-oncology is a boon or bane, and how much significant is this in today's world, especially considering countries like India. So we have a very experienced and very knowledgeable panelists who are going to discuss various topics from the scope to the coping, spirituality, sexuality, the psychological rehabilitation, childhood, oncological issues and various aspects of that. The mode of presentation, we are going to discuss 6 to 7 minutes, each of the presenter will come one by one, and followed by, we'll keep an open platform to discuss, maybe for 1 and 2 minutes, maximum 2 questions. I will expect everybody will come up with their queries and make our discussion more fruitful, followed by with a discussion of the panel, will sum up and wrap up the session with the take-home messages from this panel discussion. So here I request Mrs. Reena Raj, who is a lecturer at the College of Nursing, KGM, Lucknow, who is going to discuss about psycho-oncology, the concept, component, and scope. So over to Mrs. Reena Raj.
This is not basically 90. This is 10 lakh of people. Then in 205 and male and 165 females are there. They are diagnosed as a cancer patient. In that, 40% of them, they are prevalent of cancer across the world, and it is most found in developed countries. Next slide, please. So I should introduce what is psycho-oncology. Psycho-oncology is a sub-speciality of cancer, and this is dealing with the reaction of cancer with the families of cancer patients, and it is also dealing with the social aspect of behavior and related psychological aspect of the cancers. Next slide, please. The scope of cancer is psychology of cancer. There is an oncologist, social worker, Then psychologist also is there, psychotherapist, nurses as well, and the most team, they are dealing with psycho-oncology. This is one of the specialized group nowadays been only dealing with the psychological aspect of oncology. The people who are just diagnosed with the cancer, and you must know that how much they are just going and getting depressed to know the crisis what will be happened after the diagnosis. So I would like to explain this slide. This slide is what is Kubler-Ross grief cycle of depression. This shows that this was Elizabeth, given by Elizabeth Kubler. This was, she is a Swedish psychologist. She says that there are five phases of grief. This grief is giving us many signs and symptoms. With that sign and symptoms, we can find that people, how they are going into the depression and how they can overcome with the crisis intervention, how the nurses can recognize about this this intervention. So the problem, like this was a figure, this may not be clear in front of you. This was being given by, this is called David screen photography. He shows that while having grief, they will have all these problems, and then we have to help them to overcome.
I am talking about depression. There are different behavioral, psychological, cognitive changes of the person. I am focusing only on psychological integrity, how that affect depression. Loss of ambition, lack of interest, and also all the areas. Activities, sex, and libido, all the things are not positive for the person. Feelings of boredom, sadness, and fearfulness, and also helplessness, hopelessness, powerlessness. These are the major determinants that person can lead to even committing suicide. Person has low self-esteem, feeling of inadequacy, attention and concentration deficit. Those are the problem with the person when the person develops depression. In addition, decision-making difficulty and also dependent behavior, violence sometimes, higher exposure to suicide. There is unfortunate condition among cancer patients because they are always treated in cancer hospital or cancer unit. Cancer unit, all the experts are oncologists, not the psychiatrists. Very rarely referred these people to the psychiatrist because they believe that people with cancer has common sign of symptoms because of the cancer. Therefore, depression is not diagnosis upon cancer patient, just symptomatic treatment given, but there is a big issue in the sector. Right, anxiety and depression both are inseparable. You can see situational anxiety, disease-related anxiety, treatment-related anxiety, and also exacerbation of the pre-existing anxiety disorders can support this person with anxiety. The previous presenter talked about this grieving process. I just focus on one area, denial. At the stage of denial, person doesn't want to accept the disease condition. That is the only thing happening with the person's mind. He refused the diagnosis. Then he is going through this kind of grieving process, finally end up with depression. He's not going to accept. That is why person developed depression. Person is dwelling in the stage of depression without going to the acceptance level. Therefore, person always develop depression. This grieving cycle was found with the large number of group of people, those who are going to die, observed in a qualitative manner by the person Kubler-Ross. The person used this special qualitative approach to identify this thing. It is called ethnography study.
2 minutes more.
Right. As you know, cancer patient, we can talk about cancer patient in a different way. Diagnosis always leading to psychological issues.
And he is that much committed to his duties and responsibilities. And he's a very approachable person. Anybody can meet him at any time. And if you come with any problem, he will try every effort to resolve it as soon as possible. dignitaries of the stage. I thank you all for reposing your faith in me, and especially Madam Dr. Darshan Sohi, recently who has been bestowed with the Government of India highest award in the nursing profession, that is the International Florence Nightingale Award, by President Dr. Ram and our President of India, this Dr. R. L. Cohen. She has been given on the 12th of May, the birthday of Florence Nightingale. So before I begin my speech, I give my revered thanks and my heartfelt gratitude and my soul to the living legend of Chief Khalsa Diwan, that is Bhai Veer Singh Ji, who started this organization way back in the year 1902. His works are so much commendable, not only for Punjabi literature, for promotion and promulgation of Punjabi literature, but also for women empowerment in that prehistoric India, starting from prehistoric India to the India which was not independent at that time. So the non-independent India to the medieval India, and now coming towards the independent India, he was conferred the highest literature award by the Government of Punjab in those times and by the President of India of those times, with the Sahitya Kala Academy Award in those times. So he also got the India's highest fourth highest civilian order, that is the Padma Shri, by the Government of India. So it is because of his will and wish, his legendary vision, that we all are sitting here and we are enjoying the patronage and shelter of this Chief Khalsa of the Law Society, which has more than 56 colleges. So before I begin my presentation, next slide please. I will say next slide to the next slide. Okay, next slide. Unfolding the mysteries of cancer patient, redefining oncology nursing, blending cure with care. What was the motivation for me to choose this topic? Dr. Darshan Sohi met me long back in one of the SDRD institutes in Panvel. Madam Hadizar is sitting here. I met her over there. She asked me, ma'am, please help me in getting some good resource persons and please help me organizing the conference. So I just helped her totally, unconditionally. On her mutual trust, she will be showing her best. The motivation was the country where the WHO has given me as a country head, as a nursing advisor, is one of the most poverty-stricken countries of the world, most vulnerable countries of the world, resource-constrained countries of the world. Every 8 minutes we have one girl dying because of postpartum hemorrhage, postpartum eclampsia, and different, you can say, pregnancy-related complications. In this country, there is no treatment for cancer. There is not even a single nurse who is trained in giving chemotherapy. All patients who are rich enough, who can go to Ghana. Ghana is a very nearby country. They go to Ghana, they come to Indonesia, they go to Malaysia, different countries for radiotherapy and the injections of chemotherapy, they carry with them and nurses, they apply there. Yeah, and wholesome fruits and vegetables. Consume them at the maximum. Please limit your carbohydrate intake. Eat maximum proteins, and proteins are the building blocks of the body. Next slide. This is sauna. This is a sauna bar. What is happening in sauna, you get a lot of perspiration and steam. Every other room boom khul jate hain aapke. After exercise, you can even go for a, these are the complementary therapies in cancer care. Complementary as well as the alternative medicine. Yoga hai, pranayama hai, aromatherapy is there. So these all come in the alternative therapies in cancer care. Not even cancer care, these are part of your lifestyle factors. If you improve your lifestyle, I think you will never get cancers. Next. So you can see here, meditation. Big role of meditation in prevention of your stress. For your stress ke jo aapke hormones hain, itna stress hota hai ki sometimes you even have a burnout. That is the last stage of stress is burnout. Yes or no? Okay, the best thing is either avoid stress, avoid the energy, avoid the stress, or fight and flight. Do it is only either parasympathetic nervous system or you'll get this fight and flight. So make sure that you don't have these kind of formatants inside the body. Next. So aging happens individually, no two persons become old in exactly the same manner, no two parts of body become old in exactly the same way, no two cells in the body become old exactly in the same way. Remember, kabhi do cell ikatthe old nahi hote, kabhi do body organs hote, kabhi do individuals bhi old nahi hote. Remember that very well. This is the crux of biogerontology and how biogerontology is related to cancer prevention, cancer control and cancer rehabilitation. So this is a new concept that I want to tell you. Next slide. So advancing age is the most important risk factor for the cancer overall. As you get older, you tend to have more potential. Old age, you have eating habits to control, nahi rehta, movement to control, nahi hota, exercise over, nobody is taking care of the person. So as you grow old, you have to have a multidisciplinary systems for your coping, your nutrition and for your exercise to give you health. So now we develop, this is the last line, last line is very important. We develop pre-cancerous cells, our our whole life, but when we are young, our immune system is very strong and it is able to target those cells and kill them. So pre-cancer cells in your body mein aapki jo hai young age se hi banne shuru ho jate hain, and till you go towards your old age they go on multiplying and multiplying, but that is your immunity and your genetic makeup and how you are able to cope up with them. It's all depending on the internal systems inside your body at the level of your genetic makeup or at the level of your inside DNA.
What about your cancer and sexuality? We all know that cancer is a life-threatening disease and it can affect both men, women and even children, and it can affect every part of the body. And after affecting the body, it can cause anatomical and physiological, you know, impact on the body, that physical effect and also functional effect of the body. Also, treatment of cancer, we have seen even yesterday from the various presentations that it can, you know, cause several complications and side effects. And also, we know that trend in cancer is really alarming right now. And globally, it is regarded as the second leading cause of death. Mortality also is very high, with the bulk of the deaths occurring in developing countries. For Sierra Leone, where I'm coming from, West Africa, it's really, really alarming. As you can see the figures there, an estimated annual incidence of 2,800 deaths, and also the death is also equal to the incidence. You know, that is very, very alarming. And also another fact about cancer is that the affordability and also the availability of the treatment is very, very challenging everywhere, even in developed countries. Now, what is sexuality? At times, people, when you hear about sexuality, you may think that it's just about sexual activities, but that is not all. Sexuality encompasses a lot. It tells us, it reflects our personality. According to WHO, sexuality is a central aspect of human being throughout life, and it encompasses sex, gender identifications, roles, sexual orientations, and sexual well-being. It relates to the sexuality, I mean. It is influenced by biological, psychological, and social, cultural, and even religious, you know, factors. But this very, very important, you know, quality of life issue is said to be really hardly talked about in healthcare system, especially in cancer patients. Now, does cancer impact sexuality? Of course, the answer should be yes, because sexuality, you know, reflects our personality, and because of that, any type of cancer, regardless of wherever it is located, it can affect our personality.
Life. And there are no follow-up for the patients. They do not understand what are the difficulties they are undergoing. There are six components. Number one, there has to be an annual checkup of these patients. Every year, you have to check up after the treatment process. Then there has to be blood testing. All of you must remember that when you are doing a cancer therapy, the blood glucose level goes very high, and sometimes it goes and ends up in diabetes also. I have published a paper in British Journal of Cancer some time ago. Same way, the third one is diagnostic imaging is very, very important. Nutritional health is very important. Mental health is very, very important. And the first paper was trying to talk about training person. I think Madam, Hong Kong Madam was talking about that. That is the training that you have to impart.
What do you think?
Yes.
So there is a research in spirituality and health study. 108 women undergoing treatment for gynec cancer, and when asked what helped them cope with their gynecological cancer, so 93% of the women cited spiritual beliefs. 75 of these patients stated that religion had a significant place in their life, and 49% of women, they said they had become more spiritual after their diagnosis of the cancer. So research spirituality health, some observation studies suggested that people who have a regular spiritual practice tend to live longer. Patients who are spiritual may utilize their beliefs in coping with illness, pain and life stress. And those who are spiritual tend to have a more positive outlook and a better quality of life, more satisfied with their lives, were happier and had less pain. They experience, pain is there, but they experience very less pain. All of you know who is this person? Anyone can? Who is this person? Yuvraj Singh. He's my favorite cricketer. So positive thinking. What he gave his interview, he said, cancer has taught me a lot of things. Cancer does not mean death. Don't be scared. Be positive. Please don't think that your life is about to end. Because when patient heard about that he had a cancer, that time only he thought about his death. Take the right advice and act as soon as you can. If there is an issue in your system, don't ignore it.
Why must we hear the stories told with such intensity? Or we hear the similar stories so often? Or we have the gift or the curse of extreme empathy and we suffer. We feel the feeling of our patients. We experience their fears. We dream their dreams. Eventually, we lose a spark of optimism, humor, and hope. We tire, we aren't sick, but we aren't ourselves. So, you know, what is the concept of the fatigue? This one, compassion fatigue. Compassion fatigue was not, it's only in the last 2 decades that it has really come into existence. The Johnsons first used this term, the loss of the ability to nurture, in a study of emergency department nurses in 1992. Later on in 1995, patients usually they are having the negative thoughts, and those thoughts are automatic negative thoughts which are always distorting the mind of a person, and that can be modified through the cognitive restructuring. Here means we have to develop the patient the positive thoughts instead of deleting their negative thoughts which are distorting the patient all the time. That we can do for cognitive, because here the therapist and the patient has to sit together and they have to discuss their, patient has to list their negative thoughts, and that's being modified by discussing with the therapist. Second is the behavioral change and the development. Here we have to ask the patient that what they do when they face with the problems, and we have to help them to identify those alternative behaviors which are more helpful to them, and ask about the strategies which they are using in other stressful situations. That might be helpful to the patient, the family, and their caregivers.
signifies illumination of minds with paramount wisdom and knowledge, and removal of ignorance and dearth of knowledge, same as light brings brightness and dispels darkness.
It was in late 17th century, about 1696, when our 10th master, Guru Gobind Singh, was fighting with the Mughal forces. One of his disciples, Bhai Kanhaiya Ji, was assigned that duty is to provide water to the wounded. Bhai Kanhaiya Ji did his duty very well, without making any distinction between the enemy and the own forces. This was complained to the Guruji, and he was called, and Guruji asked him, "Can this is a complaint against you?" He said, "My Lord, I only see the creation of Almighty in all of them. I don't know whether he is our own soldier or he is an enemy." The Guruji smiled and patted his back and said, "Na ko bari, na hi begana." I would like to welcome all the eminent speakers who have come from different countries, like Madam Rebecca Amra and Mr. Basiljor Baylor from West Africa, Dr. Sudhar Thetmi from Sri Lanka, Dr. Suresh Khanna from USA, Mrs. Asia Ibrahim from Maldives, Dr. Winnie from Hong Kong, Madam Shabnam Sultana from Bangladesh, Madam T.J. Masamba from South Africa, as well as various parts of the country like Dr. Abba Abraham Agarwal from New Delhi, Ms. Felicia Chitra, and Ms. Rebecca Sampson from Pondicherry, Dr. Tani Mati from Odisha, Sister Mary Georges, Mrs. Patepa Jagdish, and Dr. Parul Kibiwala from Mumbai, Brahma Kumaris Rupa Vadya, and Brahma Kumari Sashibala from Rajasthan, Mrs. Prakash Kaur from Jammu and Kashmir, Dr. Dastagir Sultan Sharif, and Mr. Munaraya from Chennai, Mrs. Reena Raj from Lucknow, and Mr. Rajit Kaur from Barusar, and many more respected guests and speakers. I also welcome the students from various parts of the country, from Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab, Haryana, from Uttarakhand, Madhya Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Pondicherry, and all various other places. And I welcome all. Thank you.
Isn't it actually that from darkness take enlighten me into what is this called? From darkness to enlightenment. Enlightenment is the word actually. The second question which will arise in your minds is, where have we come to? Who are these people? Well, Chief Khalsa Diwan, the organization which set up this college, was founded in 1902 in a dark period. Why I say this is referring to the lamp also. Dark period because by then, let me take you to some statistics. A Britisher wrote an article in 1890. He had dissected the literacy rate of the Punjab, comparing it with the rest of India, and also comparing it with the European countries. He says in his article that Punjab's literacy rate is even better than that in Europe. The East India Company, which before 1857 ruled the country, didn't quite like it. They had some people go into the people's houses and burn the textbooks. It might surprise you that the women were more literate than the men. So the books were burned, the literacy rates came down, and we, the intellectuals in the Sikh sect, felt that we have to revive it. Therefore, Chief Khalsa Diwan was founded purely for the purpose of education. Around 270 schools were created between 1902 and 1947. Most of them were left in Pakistan, and the few that were left in the current Indian province of Punjab were taken over by either the municipalities or the government, and we had to start from a scratch in 1967. And we today have around 53 schools, 3 colleges. Now coming to this college, we dreamt of it in 2010, and we were able to put it into functioning position. We didn't have any hiccups, so to say, in the bringing up of this college, because we were fortunate enough in having who are the people who really brought this college up. Dr. Manmohan Singh Khanna, a founder, a former principal of Government Medical College. Dr. S.S. Walia, a former director principal of Guru Ramdas Medical College. Dr. Inderbir Nijjar, the foresight of our then president and the current president. A host of other doctors within the fraternity, within the Chief Khalsa Diwan, they were responsible for bringing up this college. And today, it is a pride. It is a pride for us that a lot of our students have passed out and gone abroad as well. I intentionally mention that because to the students who might be listening, you are needed here in this country.
Baba Fried University of Health Sciences, Faridkot, Sardar Tanda Singh Ji, Honorable President Chief Khalsa Diwan, Dr. Santokh Singh Ji, founder of this college, Dr. S.S. Walia Ji, Dr. Inderbir Singh Nijjar, Sardar Prabhjot Singh Sethi Ji, Dr. Gagandeep Singh Ji, Professor S.S. Sheena Ji. It is my great pleasure to extend warm welcome to each of you. I also welcome again to our international and national guest speakers, experts, and resource persons from USA, Hong Kong, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, West Africa, South Africa. I welcome to all delegates from various states of India, Rajasthan, Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Arunachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Gujarat, and many more. Above all, I express my gratitude to Madam Radha Saini, WHO consultant, who is main organizer and coordinator of this program. We can say she is the brain of this program. I welcome you all again. Now I will hand over the mic to Vice Principal Madam Arlene Kaur for a few minutes.
Welcome to this conference. I am going to speak about this holy city and about our college. Only small brief view with picturization only. I will not take much more time. Welcome to Holy City Amritsar. This city was founded by the fourth Sikh Guru, Shri Guru Ram Das Ji, in 1577 AD. The name Amritsar is made of two words, Amrit plus Sar. Amrit means holy water and Sar means sarovar tank. It is believed that the holy water has therapeutic medicinal properties and pilgrims can purify their souls by taking dip into this water. Next, this slide. It is of these are the pioneers of CKD Charitable Society. Pai Arjun Singh Ji, Sardar Sundar Singh Ji Majithia, Pai Veer Singh Ji, Sardar Harbhajan Singh Ji Adari, Sardar Talochan Singh Ji, Principal Jodh Singh Ji, Sardar San Singh Ji, Sardar Kirpal Singh Ji, Sardar Dulbir Singh Ji. Next slide is about CKD Charitable Society. This is a one oldest society, Sikh educational organization, which is founded by the group of Sikh stalwarts in 1902 with an aim to promote the spiritual, intellectual, moral, social, educational and economic welfare of the Sikhs, as well as to safeguard the political rights by making the government aware of the problems, needs and grievances of the Sikh community. At present, the society has more than 500 members who all are very learned personalities like retired professors from medical colleges, IAS officers, successful businessmen, etc. And all these members work tirelessly for the betterment and upliftment of institutes and schools. This society is running more than 50 public schools, namely Shri Guru Har Krishan Public School, two old age homes, one is in Amritsar and one is at Tarantaran, one orphanage home, and more than 300 orphans are residing in that orphanage, two management and technology colleges, and one nursing college where we are sitting. CKD Hospital, and it includes allopathic, homeopathic, dental, physiotherapy and Ayurvedic wings. Now I'm going to tell you with picturization only about the Chief Khalsa Diwan International Nursing College. It was established in 2012, as already you know, Dr. Santokh Singh Ji, founder of this college, former president, CKD Charitable Society. They are very hardworking and dedicated.
Dr. Santokh Singh Ji, Walia Sahab, Inderbir Nijjar Sahab, Rabjot Ji, ਖੰਨਾ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਸ਼ਾਮ ਬੜੀ ਜੀ ਆਇਆਂ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਿੱਖਇਜ਼ਮ ਹੈ ਸੀਕੇਡੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਸਾਡੀ ਜਮਾਤ ਹੈ ਸਿੱਖਇਜ਼ਮ ਨਾਲ ਜੁੜੀ ਹੈ ਵਿੱਚ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਸੇਵ ਕਮਾਈਏ ਅਤੇ ਇੱਧਰ ਕੇ ਵੈਸਣ ਪਾਈਏ ਅਗਰ ਦੁਨੀਆ 'ਚ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸੇਵਾ ਦਾ ਮੌਕਾ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਤਾਂ ਉਹ ਪ੍ਰਭੂ ਦੇ ਚਰਨਾਂ 'ਚ ਬੰਦਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਅਤੇ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਨਰਸਿੰਗ ਕਾਲਜ ਦਾ ਸੁਪਨਾ ਹੈ ਸਾਡੇ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦਾ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਅੱਜ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਹੋ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਇਹ ਫੁੱਲ ਬੂਟੇ ਨੂੰ ਪੈਦਾ ਕੀਤਾ ਜੀ ਅਤੇ ਨਰਸਿੰਗ ਕਾਲਜ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਇਹ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਖਾਹਿਸ਼ ਸੀਗੀ ਔਰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਦਿਨ ਰਾਤ ਇੱਕ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਸ ਕਾਲਜ ਨੂੰ ਅੱਜ ਬੁਲੰਦੀਆਂ 'ਤੇ ਲਿਆਂਦਾ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਕਹਿਣ ਦੀ ਝਿਜਕ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਾਫੀ ਨਰਸਿੰਗ ਕਾਲਜ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਬੱਚੇ ਹਾਜ਼ਰੀ ਲਵਾ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਅਤੇ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਈ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਦੇ ਉਹ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਕੈਰੀਅਰ ਖਰਾਬ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੋ ਇਹ ਸਾਡੇ ਕਾਲਜ ਇਹ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਸਟ੍ਰਿਕਟ ਹੈ ਇੱਥੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੂਰੀ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਈ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਬੱਚੀਆਂ ਕਾਫੀ ਕਾਬਲ ਨੇ ਔਰ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰਦੀਆਂ ਮੈਂ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਉਮੀਦ ਕਰਨਾ ਕਿ ਜੋ ਸੀਕੇਡੀ ਦਾ ਮਿਸ਼ਨ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰਨੀ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਈ ਅੱਛੀ ਕਰਾਉਣੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਚੈਰੀਟੇਬਲ ਵੀ ਹਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਦੁਨੀਆ 'ਚ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਲ ਜੋੜਨ ਵਾਲੇ ਵੀ ਹਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਸੋ ਸਾਡਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਿੱਖਇਜ਼ਮ ਦਾ ਮਿਸ਼ਨ ਹੈ ਜੇ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰਦ ਹੋ ਨਕਾਮੀ ਤਿਸ ਕੋ ਹੋਰ ਪ੍ਰਾਪਤ ਸਵਾਮੀ
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਸਰ Good afternoon, everyone. Myself is Dr. Parmeez Kaur, and I am working as lecturer in College of Nursing, GMC, at Sector 32, Chandigarh. I am feeling here exuberantly fortunate to acquaint you all with the chief guest of this conjuncture. He is Dr. Raj Bahadur, Vice Chancellor, Baba Fried University of Health Sciences, Faridkot. Sir is also Project Director and Member Secretary to Regional Spinal Injury Center, Mohali. To his credit, sir has more than 39 years of teaching and research experience, and he is competently serving at various administrative levels for more than two decades. As Vice Chancellor of Baba Fried University of Health Sciences, he has made vital achievements and contributions in terms of continuing education, establishing newer units and technologies in hospital, digital evaluation system in university, and special mention to settling of another constituent institute to university, that is Nursing College Jalalabad. Sir is revered member to various nurse societies and academic organizations at state, regional and national level. He has myriad of paper presentations, guest lectures and publications too. Sir has been acclaimed with recognition awards, excellency awards, lifetime achievement awards, Punjab Ratan, Himachal Gaurav Puraskar, state award for exemplary services, and the accolade continues.
Besides these laudations, sir, it is highly modest that he prompted for this event. Thank you so much, sir. And now I humbly request you to take over the dais and share your views. Welcome, sir.
Good afternoon, friends. Honorable Sardar Dhanraj Singh Ji, the chief of CKD institutions, otherwise too he deserves being the senior most person sitting here in this conference. He is seconded by two eminent doctors, not only doctors, but two professors, a professor of surgery, Professor Santokh Singh, Professor of Anesthesia, Professor Balia. I, being a surgeon, I can imagine an institution which could be strengthened by surgeon and anesthetist certainly has very deep foundations. Because the commitment of these two faculties in medical science is one which deals essentially with the energy. See, my country, I would love that they should stand, the rest of the people should see, and we should give clap for their presence in this conference. Friends, I am emotionally choked to see you, that you have come all the way from different places where the poverty is existing to the level where one need to even get difficulties to find a piece of bread to live. And not only that, but you are taking challenge of learning nursing education and impart that nursing education to the rest of the society in your country, and for that you deserve a applause from all of us. Thank you. And this is essentially by Radha Sen. Radha name for this country as such is also very familiar, as Radha is associated with Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is not complete without Radha. Lord Krishna was married to Rukmini, but the soul of Krishna was Radha. So I believe that in this country, in this province, the soul of nursing lies in Radha, and she is one of the. Having said that, I am today elated that one of the affiliated colleges of Baba Fi University of Health Sciences is of this standard. I have not seen the infrastructure, but the level of the guests you have invited from the various countries, mere their presence indicates that you have indeed a strength to call people to make them see the institutions, and that would be our projection for the nursing profession in Baba Fi University of Health Sciences. A nurse who is going into the society, the level of compassion should be as high as possible. Having said that, why we are now talking about the care of the cancer patient with the help of the nurses. So the so-called the oncology nursing, it is a new specialty. And I am very pleased to tell to you that the Baba Fi University of Health Sciences has its one affiliated college, which has been declared as an institution, that is Homi Baba Cancer Institute or Cancer Hospital at Sangrur, is starting the first ever course of an oncology nurse. We are sensitive to this, and that course has been started. And any student who has done his BSc probably can opt for that course. It is 1 year course with 1 year bond, and in the bond period you are given some money so that you are able to survive in addition to that. So what I am trying to say is that this course, oncology course in the Baba Fiji University of Health Sciences, is at the same level where you are discussing today the care of the cancer patient with the oncology nurse. Why the oncology nurse is important? Why not a general nurse can take the care of a patient of a cancer? The scenario is different. Unfortunately, the training program and the commitment of the nurses, which I usually see in the public sector hospital, is, as I mentioned, and the doctor has dwindled. Unfortunately, they have just focused for taking the vitals of the patient, A, taking care of the records or the linen of the in the hospital. So-called, what is required out of them, the care which they should give for compassion, holding the hand of the patient, that is missing. So if you load this nurse who is taking care of the record, the linen, the general vital, I think this specialized branch of oncology nursing probably will not be able to do well. So therefore, oncology nursing requires a committed people, a committed training, because when we do the chemotherapy, when we put the catheter for chemotherapy in the heart, and I learned today in the morning itself from the person who is organizing this program at Sangaroo, it is the nurse who will put the catheter from the arm into the heart for providing the chemotherapy. It is a trained nurse which has to put the cannula in the vein of the patient, and the drugs, the chemotherapy drugs, they are so toxic that if they come out of the vein, they will produce an ulcer there, it can produce a fibrosis, and it can produce the decay of the tendons which are present there. So a committed girl with the knowledge of a BSc nursing has to come forward to take this challenge.
ਬੱਚੇ ਪਰਸਨ ਦੀਆਂ ਪੂਰੀਆਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਸਹਾਇਤਾ ਕਰਨ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੂਰੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰ ਕੇਅਰ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਾਈਡ ਕਰਨ ਅਕੋਰਡਿੰਗ ਟੂ ਦੀਅਰ ਨੀਡਸ, ਜੋ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਨੀਡਸ ਹੈਗੀਆਂ ਨੇ. ਅਤੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲਈ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਾਡਾ ਸਾਰਾ ਸਟਾਫ ਰਲ ਮਿਲ ਕੇ ਪੂਰੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ PPT ਪ੍ਰੈਜੈਂਟੇਸ਼ਨਸ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪ੍ਰੈਕਟੀਕਲ ਕਰਵਾਉਂਦੇ ਨੇ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਲੀਨਿਕਲ ਏਰੀਆ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਪ੍ਰੈਕਟਿਸ ਕਰਵਾਉਂਦੇ ਨੇ, ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਗਾਈਡੈਂਸ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ, ਸਾਰੀ ਟੀਚਿੰਗਸ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ, ਈਵਨ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟਸ ਤੋਂ ਡੈਮੋ ਲਈਆਂ ਜਾਂਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ, ਰੀਡ ਐਡਮਿਨਿਸਟ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਲਈਆਂ ਜਾਂਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ, ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਚੰਗੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗ ਸਕੇ ਕਿ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੇ ਪੇਸ਼ੈਂਟ ਨੂੰ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੀ ਕੇਅਰ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਾਈਡ ਕਰਨੀ ਆ. ਅਤੇ ਅਗਰ ਉਹ ਕੋਈ ਵੀ ਕੇਅਰ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਾਈਡ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਿਸੇ ਵੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੀ ਕੋਈ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਖਾਮੀ ਰਹਿ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ, ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਟੀਚਰਸ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਟੀਚ ਕਰਕੇ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਗਾਈਡੈਂਸ ਦੇ ਕੇ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਪੂਰੀ ਤਿਆਰੀ ਕਰਵਾ ਕੇ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਭੇਜਦੇ ਨੇ, ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਅੱਗੇ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਉਹ ਸਾਰੇ ਸਟਾਫ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਾਡੇ ਕਾਲਜ 'ਚ ਗਿਆ ਹੈਗਾ ਪੇਸ਼ੈਂਟਸ ਨੂੰ ਚੰਗੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਪੂਰੀ ਦੇਖ ਰੇਖ ਪ੍ਰੋਵਾਈਡ ਕਰ ਸਕੇ.
ਇੱਥੇ ਮੈਂ ਐਡ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹਾਂਗੀ ਇੱਕ ਹੋਰ ਵਾਈਸ ਪ੍ਰਿੰਸੀਪਲ ਮੈਡਮ ਮਿਸਟਰ ਕੁਮਾਰ ਨੂੰ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਕੈਂਸਰ ਹੈ 30-40% ਕੈਂਸਰ ਪ੍ਰਿਵੈਂਟੇਬਲ, ਟ੍ਰੀਟਮੈਂਟ ਤਾਂ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਨੇ ਕਰਨਾ, ਡਿਟੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਨੇ ਕਰਨੀ ਹੈ, ਪਰ ਇਹ 30-40% ਜਿਹੜੀ ਪ੍ਰਿਵੈਂਸ਼ਨ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਨਰਸਿਸ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ. ਨਰਸਿਸ ਨੇ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ 'ਚ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੇ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ 'ਚ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਨਾ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟ ਕੰਟੈਕਟ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਰਹਿੰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ, ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਪੇਸ਼ੈਂਟ ਦੇ ਕੋਲ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਟਾਈਮ ਨਰਸਿਸ ਸਪੈਂਡ ਕਰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪਤਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਪ੍ਰਿਵੈਂਟ ਕਰਨਾ, ਉਹਦੇ ਪ੍ਰਿਵੈਂਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਐਜੂਕੇਟ ਕਰਨਾ, ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਐਜੂਕੇਟ ਇਹ ਕਰਨਾ ਕਿ ਲਾਈਫ ਸਟਾਈਲ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਾਫੀ ਚੇਂਜਿਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਸ ਟਾਰਗੇਟ ਨੂੰ ਅਚੀਵ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਪ੍ਰਿਵੈਂਟ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ. ਸਪੋਜ ਲਾਈਫ ਸਟਾਈਲ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਫਾਸਟ ਫੂਡ ਵਗੈਰਾ ਅਵੋਇਡ ਕਰੋ, ਅੱਛੀ ਡਾਇਟ ਲਓ, ਪ੍ਰੋਟੀਨ ਲਓ, ਐਂਟੀ ਆਕਸੀਡੈਂਟਸ ਲੈਣੇ ਚਾਹੀਦੇ ਆ, ਐਕਸਰਸਾਈਜ਼, ਯੋਗਾ, ਜਿਹਦੇ ਵੀ ਸਾਡੇ ਨੈਚੁਰਲ ਥੈਰੇਪੀਜ਼ ਹੈ, ਨੇਚਰ ਕਿਓਰ ਦੇ ਜਿੰਨੇ ਵੀ ਮੈਥਡਸ ਨੇ, ਇਹ ਨਰਸਿਸ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਬੈਸਟ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਨੂੰ ਐਕਸਪਲੇਨ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ, ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਬਿਮਾਰੀਆਂ ਤੋਂ ਬਚਾਅ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾ ਸਕੇ. ਮੈਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਐਗਜਾਮਪਲ ਦਿਆਂਗੀ, ਮੈਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਰਿਸਰਚ ਕੀਤੀ ਸੀ 400 ਟੀਚਰਸ ਦੇ ਉੱਪਰ, ਹਰ ਕਿਸ਼ਨ ਪਬਲਿਕ ਸਕੂਲਾਂ ਦੇ 400 ਟੀਚਰ ਸੀ, ਅਤੇ ਬ੍ਰੈਸਟ ਕੈਂਸਰ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਡਿਟੈਕਟ ਕਰੀ, ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਸੀਗਾ ਕਿ ਬ੍ਰੈਸਟ ਸੈਲਫ ਐਗਜਾਮੀਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਇੱਕ ਮੈਥਡ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ, ਹਰ ਮਹੀਨੇ ਕਰਦੇ ਰਹੋ, ਅਤੇ ਉਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਅਰਲੀ ਡਿਟੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ, ਜੇ ਅਰਲੀ ਡਿਟੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਉਹਦਾ ਟ੍ਰੀਟਮੈਂਟ ਵੀ ਪੂਰਾ ਹੋਏਗਾ, ਅਤੇ 20-25-30 ਸਾਲ ਤੱਕ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ ਲਾਈਫ ਵੱਧ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ. ਐਗਜਾਮਪਲ ਦੇ ਤੌਰ 'ਤੇ ਮੇਰਾ ਆਪਦਾ ਆਪਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੈ, ਮੈਨੂੰ ਬ੍ਰੈਸਟ ਕੈਂਸਰ ਸੀ 20 ਸਾਲ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ, ਅਤੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਆਈ ਹੈ ਬੇਸ਼ੱਕ ਇਹ ਅਰਲੀ ਸਟੇਜ 'ਚ ਕੱਢਣੀ ਗਈ ਹੈ, ਅਤੇ ਉਹਨੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਅਵੇਅਰ ਕਰਾਂ. ਉਹ 400 ਟੀਚਰ ਦੀ ਮੈਂ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਚੈੱਕ ਕੀਤੀ ਸੀਗੀ, ਜਿਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਐਵਰੇਜ ਅਤੇ ਪੂਅਰ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਵਾਲੇ ਮੈਕਸੀਮਮ ਟੀਚਰ ਸੀ. ਆਪ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਮੈਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਟੀਚਿੰਗ ਦਿੱਤੀ, ਡੈਮੋਸਟ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਕੀਤੀਆਂ, ਵੀਡੀਓ ਦਿਖਾਈਆਂ, ਅਤੇ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਜਦੋਂ ਦੁਬਾਰਾ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਅਸੈਸ ਕੀਤੀ ਅਤੇ 75% ਐਕਸਲੈਂਟ ਅਤੇ ਗੁੱਡ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਏ. ਇਟ ਮੀਨਸ ਦੇ ਨੀਡ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਅਵੇਅਰਨੈਸ ਜੋ ਅੱਗੇ ਨਰਸਿਸ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਨ, ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਇਜਾਜ਼ਤ ਦਿੱਤੀ.
ਅਲੱਗ ਅਲੱਗ ਸਟੇਟਾਂ ਦੇ ਅਲੱਗ ਅਲੱਗ ਵਰਲਡ ਦੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਲੋਕ ਆ ਉਹ ਸਾਰੇ ਇਸ ਮਿਸ਼ਨ 'ਚ ਲੱਗੇ ਹੋਏ ਨੇ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਜੋ ਵੀ ਅਵੇਅਰਨੈਸ ਹੋ ਸਕਦੀ ਆ, ਜੋ ਵੀ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੂੰ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਗੀ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਜਾ ਸਕਦੀ ਆ ਅਸੀਂ ਦਈਏ. ਔਰ WHO ਜਿਹਦਾ ਮੰਤਵ ਇਹ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਗੀ ਦੇਣੀ ਹੈ, ਔਰ ਉਸੇ ਚੀਜ਼ ਨੂੰ ਮੁੱਖ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਹੋਏ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਲੋਕ ਆਪਣੇ ਦੇਸ਼ ਤੋਂ ਦੂਰ ਆ ਕੇ ਬੜੀ ਵੱਡੀ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਇਹ ਸਾਡੇ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਬਹੁਤ ਵੱਡੀ ਇਹ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਸਾਡੇ ਇੰਡੀਅਨ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਮਾਇੰਡ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਨੂੰ ਬਚਾਈਏ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਬਿਮਾਰੀਆਂ ਦਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਵੱਡਾ ਦੌਰ ਆ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੈਗਾ. ਕੀ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ?
ਪਹਿਲੇ ਤਾਂ ਮੈਂ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹਾਂਗੀ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਸੋਗੀ ਜੀ ਦਾ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਬੁਲਾਇਆ ਅਤੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਸਿਲੈਕਟਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਬਿਠਾਇਆ, ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਵੈਰੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਸ਼ੁਕਰੀਆ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਸਰ. ਦੂਸਰਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਮੈਨੇਜਮੈਂਟ ਦਾ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਸਰ, ਇੱਕ ਇੱਕ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ 'ਤੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਲੱਤਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਅੱਖਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਬਿਠਾ ਕੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਖਿਲਾਮ ਤੋਂ ਲੱਗ ਕੇ ਸੁਲਾਮ ਤੱਕ ਲੋੜੀਆਂ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਸੁਣਾਇਆ. ਔਰ ਅੱਜ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਕਲਚਰ ਬਿਸਾਈਡ ਉਹਨੇ ਤੋਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਨੇ ਕਈ ਲੋਕ ਬਾਹਰ ਜਾ ਕੇ NRIs ਬਣਦੇ ਨੇ, ਪਰ ਫਿਰ ਵੀ ਆਪਣੇ ਵਤਨ ਦੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈ ਖੁਸ਼ਬੂ ਜਾਂ ਮਿੱਟੀ ਇੰਨੀ ਆਕਰਸ਼ਿਤ ਕਰਦੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਦੌੜੇ ਆ ਗਏ. 50 ਸਾਲ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਹੋਤੇ ਨੇ ਆਪਣੀ ਆਪਣੀ ਜਿੰਨੀ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੀ ਖਾਸੀਅਤ ਹੈ ਜਾਂ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲਿਟੀ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਦੇ ਹਿਸਾਬ ਨਾਲ ਅਸੀਂ ਆ ਕੇ ਆਪਣਾ ਆਪਣਾ ਦਾਨ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ, ਜਿਹੜਾ ਵੀ ਸ਼ਿਕਸ਼ਾ ਦੇ ਯੋਗਦਾਨ ਦਿੰਦੇ. ਮੇਰੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਡਿਵੈਲਪਮੈਂਟ ਕਰੀਕੁਲਮ ਹੁਣ ਸਾਰੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਤੋਂ ਲੱਗੇ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਕੈਂਸਰ ਦਾ ਕਰੋ, ਕੈਂਸਰ ਦਾ ਕਰਨਾ, ਪ੍ਰੀਵੈਂਟ ਕਰਨਾ, ਕਿਉਰ ਕਰਨੀ, ਟ੍ਰੀਟਮੈਂਟ ਕਰਨੀ ਹੈ, ਪਰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਰਨ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਤਿਆਰ ਵੀ ਤਾਂ ਕਰਨਾ ਕਰੇਗਾ. ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਰਿਸ਼ੀਗੜ੍ਹ ਨੂੰ ਪੁੱਛਾਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਏਗਾ, ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਨਾ ਇਸ ਟਾਈਮ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟਸ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਉਣ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਕੋਰਸ ਵੀ ਡਿਵੈਲਪ ਕਰਨਾ ਪੈਣਾ ਕਿ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕਰਿਕੁਲਮ ਦਿਓਗੇ, ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਚਲਾਓਗੇ, ਔਰ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਸੋਰਸਿਸ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ. ਉਹ ਸਾਰੇ ਜਿੰਨੀ ਜਿੰਨੀ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲਿਟੀ ਹੈ 15 ਕੁਝ ਲੱਗਾ ਹੋਇਆ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੂੰ ਸਾਈਕੋਲੋਜੀ ਦਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੂੰ ਕੁਛ ਮੇਰਾ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਮੈਂ ਤਾਂ ਉਹ ਕਹਿ ਰਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਜਿਸ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਮਾਸ਼ਰ ਨੂੰ ਟ੍ਰੇਨ ਕਰਨਾ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਨੂੰ ਪਛਾਣ ਔਰ ਕਰਦੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬਾਕੀ ਨੂੰ
ਕੈਸੀ ਨਾਮ ਦਾ ਬਿਮਾਰੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਕਿ ਅੱਜ ਇੰਨੀ ਤੇਜ਼ੀ ਨਾਲ ਫੈਲ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਐਵੀਡੈਂਟ ਹੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਉਸ ਸਟੇਜਾਂ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗਦਾ ਜਦੋਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਦੂਰ ਹੋ ਚੁੱਕੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਆ ਔਰ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਸਟੇਜਾਂ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਪਹੁੰਚਾਉਣ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਇਹ ਸੈਮੀਨਾਰ ਕੀਤੇ ਜਾ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਅਵੇਅਰਨੈਸ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਜਾ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਜੀ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਤੋਂ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਰੂਪ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਏ ਹੋ ਗਾਈਡ ਕਰਨ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟਸ ਲਈ ਕੀ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਹੋ
ਅੱਲਾਹ ਜਾਣੇ। Thank you. Yeah. give us opportunity to train the students. And thank you, our students. Thank you so much.